Okay, day one of the bar glute challenge. All you need today for this is a smile. You can use a mat, towel, or if you have a soft, if you're on a carpeted surface, you can just stay on your carpeted surface. I'm going to link the playlist that I'm listening to in case you can't hear it loud enough, then you can kind of just blast it in the room that you're in. But I will have it playing in the background. It just might not be super loud for you guys to hear. So we're not using anything where we're going to have to follow song for song. We will just use ourselves. Have a good time. All right. So I'm gonna want you just to start in the center of your floor mat. Hopefully you're gonna hear it. I'm putting it right up here. If I come up here, I'm just gonna like to make sure I remain in the frame for you guys. You should be able to see my feet and my whole body. We're just gonna squat and lift. Pressing the weight back towards the floor. You should be able to wiggle those toes. Just do a normal squat. Eight more. Seven. Tummy's tight. Four more. All right, now you're gonna squat and lift that leg. Lift it. Squat and lift. Keeping that foot flexed, just lifting it right out of the side. So we're not flinging it, we're just lifting. Squeezing into the side of your boot. Drop and lift. Just warming up. So your squats will get a little deeper as your body starts to warm up. Four, three, two, and now take that leg to the back. Press. So you're just pressing back, squeezing in to the area where your glute meets your thigh. Keeping that flex foot, just letting that leg extend and lift. So again, we're not flinging. You're just lifting. Drop. Your hands can be doing whatever you feel comfortable doing. And keep them on your hips and leave them out right in front. Make it up in your chest. Good press. Squeeze. You start feeling some warmth in that lower portion of your body. Drop. Let's go four more. Each side. Three. Two. And one. Now listen to me. I want you to squat down. Bend or lift the hips. Drop down. And lift. And drop. Lift. Drop. So your arms are stopping those knees. Just drop knees. Hit those arms. I don't want you guys bringing the knees forward. Just warming up. Thinking about those hamstrings. Four, three, two. We're going to add on your weight. Lift, lower, lift, rise, lower, squat, lift, nice, tight. Keep a nice, long spine. If you can't go all the way to the floor, just drop, lift, bend, and run. Four, three, two, one. Hold it here. Just slide down and up. Slide those fingertips. Push those shoulder blades together. Keep that nice long spine. Eight, seven, six. Good. Four more. Three more. Two. And one. All right, we're going to come down onto the floor.
So I'm going to make sure you guys can still see me here.
In the frame. All right. So I'm going to face you on a diagonal. We're going to come down onto all fours. So think about those shoulders being right over top of those wrists. We're not arching into our back. We're lifting that belly, keeping a nice long spine. Take that right leg, extend it. Flex that foot. We're going to lift and lower. Just lifting and lowering. Not opening the hip. It's not about height. It's about keeping that leg nice and tight, nice and straight. Up. Toes up. Heels up. Toes down. Seven. I'm going to face you guys more from the front so you can see what's going to happen. Four. Three. So at any time, if you need a little more cushion for your knee, you can add a cow there. Now lift that leg up. Take that toe out to the front. The side. As far as you can go without opening the hip. You're keeping those shoulders square. Now lift that toe up and place that toe back. So you're rainbowing. So you're lifting up. Tapping side. Lifting up, tapping back. On the front, lift up, tap side. You see my hips are still stiff still. I want you to start to feel in the back side of those obliques. Yeah. Let's take a good tempo. So it's tap. Take it to your tempo that you can keep control. Tap. Tap. Back side, top back, you're rainbowing, creating that little arch. Tap, tap, eight, seven, two. Now take that toe out to the side. You're going to lift that chest up. You're going to lower those hips back down. Lift that foot. Tap into the back from the front. Lift. Tap side. Lift the chest. Squeeze that glute. Drop those hands. Rainbow to the back. Rainbow to the front. Lift it. Drop it. Lift the rainbow. Up and around. Up. Drop. And lift. Can go a little quicker. Tap, lift, drop, back. It's not about how high you rainbow that foot. Top side, lift, tall, back. I want you to feel that whole right side. That area that you don't want rolling over those pants. Think about it. Tummy's in tight. Four. Three. Two. Now rainbow that foot out to the side. Little foot up. Down with some tennis, raising the side. You're pressing that hip forward, alright? You're gonna drop back and lift. Squeeze, drop, take that quad. Lift. Think about the glute and hamstring. Drop down slow. Lift. So you're only dropping to hover over that heel. Drop and lift. I don't care how far you drop down. Just don't rest on those heels. Your legs right off to the side. Drop. Up. Drop it back. You guys should feel the front of that standing quad. Here we go. Drop. Squeeze, lift. Drop. Squeeze, lift. This right leg stays nice and straight. Drop. Lift. Drop. Lift. Jimmy, four. Three. You're going to hold it down in two. One. Hold it low. Tiny pulses. So this is small. I don't care if you're up here or all the way back. Eight. Seven. Six. That quad is burning. Four. Three, two, and one. Place those hands back down. Rainbow that back foot back. Now listen, Jim, it's straight to the side. Break through that core. All right? You're going to take that left foot back. Tap that right side out and in. You see nothing's moving. I'm tapping out, tapping in. If you need to, you can keep that left knee down. But think about being more in a plank. So you're shifted forward. Four. Three. Right glute is nice and tight. One. Hold it here. Lift that left knee if it's not already up. Draw that knee into your chest. You're going to hold it there. You're going to pipe those hips up. And bring it forward. Keep that knee drawn into your chest if you need to. Just pipe back and bring it forward. I want you working into the core. Lift up. And forward. Let's take two counts for four. Up. Two. Down. Two. Up. Two. Down. Two more. Woo! Hold it here. Bring that front foot down. We're going to set ourselves up in a pretzel. So I want you guys to look at me. My front foot. That shin is flush with an edge, okay? So I don't want it out here. I want it back. This back leg, your right leg that you've been lifting, I want the hip bone in line with the front of the knee where that knee can be behind it. We're working into that glute. I want you to lean over to the left side. If you need to, you can come down to your elbow. Otherwise, stay on your hands. This hand can be anywhere. If you need to lean further, the further over you lean and the more support yourself you give, you can lift that leg. I want you to think about lifting that leg up and down. So the whole leg is lifting. Now, if you're unable right now to lift the whole leg at any of the positions, I'd rather have you lift the knee up and down. So you're squeezing into the glute. If you put your hand right there on the outer part of your glute, you feel that muscle working. You're lifting and lowering. Up. I want you to start to feel this go all the way up the sideline. Eight. Seven. Six. You're coming in tight. Four, three, two, hold it up, tiny pulses, up, up, up. It's tiny. Again, if you need to keep the toe down, lift just the knees, ease up, up. You have the option of coming all the way over onto your forearm, but you still keep hip and knee in line. That leg's not forward. I want you pressing that hip back, squeezing tight into that glute. Up. You should feel all the way up, rising up to the ribs here. Tummy's tight. Give me eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Hold it. Flex that foot. You're going to press that foot back. Press, press. Again, you just press it back. You're not letting that leg move big. If you need to just slide that foot back, keep that leg down. You're squeezing all the middle of that cheek, okay? So think from that little area, that crease is where you're breathing through thigh all the way up to the top of your glute muscle. Press, press, press. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three. We're going to combo. You're going to give me a little lift, a little press, a little lift, a little press. Up, press back, up, press back, up, press, up, press. How was I supposed to know? Lifting and pressing. There's something wasn't right here. Okay, but baby, I shouldn't have let you go. And now you're at the side. One more. Three more. Tell me, baby. Drop it. Woo. You guys should feel that all the way up the side. All right? Guess what? You're blessed with two sides here. So we're going to go to the other side. Same flow. Opposite leg. I should be good and not hitting my little tree here. All right, guys. Back. Stack those shoulders over those wrists. All right? Extend that left leg. Flex that foot, scoop that belly up and away from the floor. You're lifting and lowering. Tell me, baby, cause I need to know now because I only want to from the glute all the way out, scooping the energy from the bottom of the foot. Lift. You can go feeling that pinch, but not opening the hip. All right? Lift that toe up and rainbow it straight down. Lift up, rainbow to the side. You may not go all the way out to the side. Remember, we're dropping our toe. We're keeping our knee placed down. We're not working the sideline. We're working through the glutes, getting into those obliques. Up, tap, lift, tap. Really brace through your core. Keep everything nice and stable. Lift up and tap it in the back. Side. And back. Last night the DJ saved my life. Drop. And lift. Drop. and lift. Drop. And lift with vacant tempo. Drop. Lift. Drop. Lift. Remember, just drop as low as you can. Feel that quad burn. You don't want to drop all the way to the floor. You don't have to, but do not rest on those heels. It's down. Up. Drop. Lift. Four. Three. Two more. You're gonna pulse it out. Good. Pulse. Little tiny pulses down. 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 So when I think about the pulses, I want you to think about just the length of your thumb. That's how big your movement is. It drops. Drop. 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 The belly's in tight. Those palms are pressed together. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring those hands back down. Bring that leg back. That left leg stays straight back. You can bring that right knee back. So if you're going to keep a knee for support, you're going to bring it back so you're in a plank. Otherwise, you're going to lift in a plank. Left foot. Tap. Center. Tap. Center. You don't have to tap all the way out to the side. You're just tapping. Tap. Center. Tap. Side. Tap. Center. 8. Scoop that belly up and away. So don't drop the hips. Don't pipe the hips. Stay nice and flat. Tap. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold that left leg in. Bring that right knee in. Pipe those hips up. 4, 3, 2, 1. And forward. 2, 3, 4. Pipe them up. And forward. And forward. One more at the floor count. Let's go a little faster. It's up. 2, and forward. 2, cut. 2, forward. 2, 2 more. You're really drawing that knee in, keeping that engagement in the core the whole time. Hold it here. Drop that leg in front. Bring yourself. The front door. Again, I like to line my front chin up with something. So you want to think of it being parallel to like the edge of the mat, the wall. This back leg is pressed back in line with your hip or behind, not in front. So I want you to keep the engagement. Again, even if that leg doesn't lift, you can squeeze through the glute, alright? Palm or forearm to the right. Other hand can be supporting. Leaning, holding onto your leg, wherever you feel comfortable. Flex that foot or point it. You're going to lift the leg up, down. Now this side for me is tight. I'm sore. So I'm struggling. I might just lift my knee. Lift, lower, lift, lower. I may not even be able to lift my knee. If I can't, I'm just going to squeeze. It's almost like a squeeze and press that hip forward. Squeeze. But I don't release and dump into it. Squeeze. Squeeze. Up. Up this side. I may have to lean. Yes, now I can get my leg lifted. Here we go. Up. 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 Four. drop that leg, break it back. Again, sliding that foot, not even lifting that leg. Pressing, you're squeezing middle of that cheek down the area where your glute meets your thigh. Press, press. Eight, seven. You should feel that pinch right there on the outside of your hip. Five, side glute. Four, three, two. Lift it up. One, and press it. Lift, press, find your hip, find your press, find your press, up. Press, up, press, lift, press, lift, press. Eight, seven, six, five, four more, three more, and one. Woo-wee! Ah, you guys, you should feel that. I want to make sure you can see me. It cuts me off on this computer. And I want to make sure I'm staying in the screen so you can see me. You should feel all right here. All right. So, I want us to stretch here. All right? So extend those legs nice and long. I want you to take first your right leg. Cross it over that left knee. Left arm comes to the outside of that left knee and just take the body a little torso twist towards that right hip. And bring it center. Left that right knee. Come out to the side. Use your hands to support you. Keep a nice long torso coming in and draw that left heel in, pressing slightly. Out with that knee, so that we're getting a little bit more of a stretch here. If you don't like being a seated, just keep standing on the chair or countertop and doing that figure four stretch standing. And now slide that foot out. Carefully take that right leg out. Bring that left foot, cross it over that right knee. Right elbow crosses on the outside of that left knee and torso twist towards that left hip. You're giving a little tug on your knee. You're not letting your knees stay out. You're kind of keeping yourself nice and tight here. Getting that stretch, supporting yourself with that arm, that stretch. And now carefully bring yourself forward to that front leg. Ooh, you had it so tight there. Come out to the side. Slide that right foot in and stretch out on that left leg. I want you to roll forward onto your toes. Knees are wide, hands are between those feet. And just rock yourself side to side. Pressing those palms into the floor or your mat. Beautiful. Heel toe. Just feel nice. You're just going to drop low. Alright, still those legs and feet. Press those palms into the floor. Keep those hips up from those toes. Feel all of the center of the face and the center of the feet. Just rock those hips side to side. And now walk those feet to your hip distance parallel. Bring those palms to the top of your feet. Pull that belly button in all the way to your spine. And you're going to slowly, slowly roll yourself up to standing. Pressing your chin to your chest. Your hips are in the very last thing you pop. Pull those shoulders up, down, and back. Sway them in the knees. Nice feet and all the way up. And as you exhale, bring those knees towards center and give yourself a round of applause. Thank you so much for being with me today, and I hope you enjoyed it and got a good burn. Maybe feel this tomorrow, and I'll see you for day two.